Hey, Matt, it's a pleasure to have you here, man. It's been awesome to see you progress so far from joining the Power Cell group. So for everyone that doesn't really know you, do you just want to give a brief introduction about your history and how you found everything so far with the course?
Yeah, sure. So the angle I'm coming from at it from is probably a little different to most others because I'm actually a vendor. So the first product that we had was Cinderella solution. I ran a lot of Facebook traffic back then, and it was, great being able to be a big affiliate for your own offer. Now we've got a couple of new offers, and Facebook's a little tough right now, especially in the niche that we're doing. So being able to use this system and run YouTube ads has been it's been absolutely amazing, to be honest. Like, just gives us so much more control over our business. So yeah, it's been great.
Yeah, so for everyone, me and Matt actually got introduced to each other because, as he just mentioned, he is actually a vendor, right? So I'm an affiliate, and everyone joining this course is like an affiliate, right? So Matt was the person who actually went out and created one of the top weight loss products that actually was like number one for ages. I remember I made heaps of money on your product, Cinderella Solution, actually. So his perspective is a little bit different because he's coming from a vendor. And I remember we were just talking on Skype, and then I offered you the opportunity to jump in the beta cell group for the YouTube method. So do you want to just discuss a little bit on your perspective of like being a vendor versus being an affiliate, and then how you found running YouTube ads to like promote your own product?
I guess like fundamentally it's different because you have much more of a vested interest in the actual offer that you're running. And then the biggest difference, I suppose, would be you don't need the margins to be as big. And of course, like you're not doing CPA, it's always rev share. But there's the back-end profit that you make as a vendor. So I have a little more flexibility in how much I can afford to spend per sale, which is nice, but I still like to approach it with an affiliate mindset. So when I'm checking my statistics, I'm really just looking at affiliate commissions and trying to keep that profit, like trying to keep a healthy ROI as an affiliate. So like when I'm running traffic, I guess it really is from an affiliate mindset. So in a way it's completely different. I have a little more security in that I know there's a little extra money in the background. But yeah, I mean, the way that I've tackled this course has been the same as everyone else. Like I'm purely as an affiliate.
When you were running Cinderella Solution, were you mainly on the vendor side and like not really running traffic and just relying on other people's traffic, or?
No, so I remember we had Cinderella sitting there for about a month before it really saw any traffic, and it was really when I figured out a Facebook ad funnel that worked really well for it that then other people started to catch on as I kind of shared my funnel with a few other people and they started running and the word just spread from there. So it was really great being like we were our biggest affiliate, or I was our biggest affiliate for Cinderella Solution for a long, long time. And then I actually lost that at one point. I think it was probably like end of 2019. Like it just became almost impossible to run on Facebook. Like weight loss was difficult enough, but then Cinderella Solution in particular became pretty hard. And so like I really lost a lot of control, I guess, over the business, because then I went from being in a position where we didn't need affiliates, but they're a nice bonus, to being like, well, affiliates were pretty much the only way we were making sales. And so this coming along right before, we launched another two offers has been absolutely huge. So we haven't even publicly launched these offers because now I'm just running my own traffic to them. And we'll probably do some optimizing before we actually do an official big launch.
And so speaking of that, so I know you've been crushing it so far, and like in like the last couple of days, you've just like hit it out of the park. So what have your, if you want to run through your stages of like when you first started, like the numbers you were seeing in like the profits to like where you are now, which is like what, like a month, 2 months in. If you just want to give everyone a rundown on sort of like your daily like profits for this business.
So I've been in the group for like 2 months, but I wasn't really taking it seriously because I always, the whole time I felt like I was just a few days away from my offer being ready and I was going to properly tackle it then. And obviously there's a lot to do when you're launching a new offer too. So I didn't have a ton of time to put into it, but well, it's like the 8th today. I started this funnel only like 10 or 11 days ago. I started it with three campaigns at $200 a day. And it was slow at the start. Like I was breaking even probably by day two on one of the campaigns. And then it really just started to pick up from there. And so it took a little playing around to get Google spending the way that I wanted it to. But for instance, on Saturday, I think I spent like $1,500 on ads and it brought in like nearly 4K. And then I figured out how to get it to actually spend properly. And on Sunday, I spent, I think, like 12,000 US and we made like 18 or 19,000 back in affiliate commissions. Yeah, so the profit, yeah, that one day was like 6,000 in affiliate commissions.
Yeah, so that's pretty insane. And coming from Facebook where like it was pretty difficult to, you know, there was all those challenges and it was also difficult to scale from then what going from like 10 days of your funnel from going like zero to like $6,000 profit. Like how does that feel? Like coming from like another business model that was like sort of more difficult to then this one that just seems to be like so much easier, you know?
Yeah, well, it's unreal right now. It feels like early days Facebook, I suppose. Like it's almost like the Wild West right now. You don't go to bed at night so stressed that you're going to lose your account when you wake up in the morning.
Yeah.
Whereas, yeah, running a lot of Facebook, that it wasn't even, you know, it wasn't about creating good ads and like running your funnel properly. Facebook is pretty much a game of can I keep my account alive while I run this? So that's completely different. And then the scaling is just so much easier. You're not trying to run like 30 dupes of a campaign to get them to perform well. Like you hit one campaign that works and then you can pretty much vertically scale it like literally overnight.
Yeah. And so with your campaign, were you just running one campaign that you were spending that money on and making the $6,000 with?
Yeah. Well, I'm always, every day I'm launching new ones, but there was one campaign in particular like the budget for that day was 15,000 or whatever of the whatever I spent. So it was pretty much all one campaign.
Yeah, and it's pretty amazing, like just waking up and instead of having like a dreaded feeling of like, is my campaign gonna crash or something? It's like I know for me, I'm waking up like way earlier to like just wake up to these like massive amounts of profits that I've never seen before.
Yeah, that's genuinely what it's been like.
Yeah. So it's pretty exciting. And also like the way we've seen it in the Power Cell group, like you've been in is like the new 1K day is like 10K days. Everyone in there has just like been like crashed, like knocking it out of the park. And you've seen it as well. It's that sort of like hockey stick of, you know, you're like testing your campaigns. Then once you hit a winner, like just throw as much money as you can into it and scale it up.
Yeah, exactly right. That's exactly what it's been like. Yeah. Well, I posted my 15K day or whatever. And, yeah, that's literally what someone said. They're like, this is the new 1K day.
Yeah. So that's massively like impressive how far you've come, like, you know, being in the group for like 2 months. And I think a lot of people, it's like all about the action, like taking the action, because as you said, you were in there for 2 months, but it wasn't until you actually started jumping in and playing around with it that within 10 days you had your success. So how have you found the process, because you come from like an affiliate marketing background, obviously as a vendor. Yeah. But how do you find the process of like creating your ads, launching your ads and monitoring your ads?
It can take a lot of time to make the videos, especially if you're a perfectionist. Like I definitely spend way too much time on my videos, but that's because like, you know, we create VSLs and like every second is critical and you want to nail it. So I think like I carry that mindset into my videos and spend too much time on them. But in terms like the actual process is very simple. I think even if you are new, like it's not going to take you a long time to learn.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. All right. Well, that's like, it's like awesome to see your results, but I think it'll be interesting because me and you have known each other for quite some time now through like Skype and Instagram and all that sort of stuff. But I don't really know much of like your backstory. So, first of all, how old are you?
32. Yeah,
32. I would have honestly guessed like 26 or something, to be honest.
Yeah, well, thanks.
But you're also in Australia. You're also Aussie, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, Melbourne. Yeah.
Melbourne. Yeah. So, take me back to like your first entrepreneurial story, like how you, cause no one just starts as an affiliate marketer. Like everyone has to go through that process and that entrepreneurial journey. So how did you end up from like, I assume working like a regular job, maybe going to university to becoming like an affiliate marketer?
Yeah. So, I went to uni twice and dropped out both times. Or deferred and never went back.
So that's what I did.
I literally did one semester of each course. I did like project management and then commerce. And I was just like, no. Like I always knew I wanted to do something entrepreneurial, but I had no idea what. So then I like did the PT thing that I think a lot of internet marketers have done. So I did personal training. And then within like a year, we opened the first gym with another PT. We partnered up and opened the gym and we found CrossFit. So the first gym was a CrossFit gym. Then after a couple of years, I got them to buy me out and open my own one.
Yeah.
So a couple of gyms and a boot camp. And then, but I always wanted to do something online because I knew the scale was there online. It's like with a gym, there's only so far you can go. So that was always what I wanted to do. And that's really how I got into it. So I pretty much never had a normal job apart from the early PT days. But yeah, I feel like where I'm at now is pretty good for a double uni dropout.
Yeah, I mean, I dropped out of uni. Like the way I see it, and like you obviously had the same thought process, is like I also did like commerce and like bachelor of business and stuff. It's like that gets you a job, right? Like that's one pathway that like gets you a job where you're going to be working in like an office, you know, doing business stuff or whatever, right? So I realized like that's not what I want to do. And I realized that the best path out of that is to find a way to make money online. And like, luckily I fell into affiliate marketing, which is, you know, been probably like the best business model out there. And as you can see, everyone in the background, you've got all those plaques for being a super affiliate, which is also
Clickbank Platinum. Yeah.
So what about, cause a lot of people have, stresses about like family and friend issues and like what their family and friends think. So did you ever have any issues about like what your sort of friends and family thought about you dropping out of university to like pursue like entrepreneurial?
Not too much really. Like I still think no one really knows what I do now. I just tell them internet marketing because I can't really be bothered explaining it, but
yeah, it's happening as well.
Yeah. No real issues. Like my parents would have preferred that I stayed in uni for sure, but you know, now they're happy.
Yeah, that's good. And, I remember on our last call, you have, I think it was like your wife, your girlfriend come in with like a child. So are you married or?
We were going to get married and then Corona got in the way of that, but we've got a 7-month-old baby. Yeah,
that's awesome. Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
That's what, like, yeah, COVID hitting's pretty much ruined like a lot of people's lives and like paths and stuff. Like I talk to a lot of friends who like can't even go to university now, or they're like just finished university and now they can't get a job. And
that's right.
I just think about like how lucky like we are and stuff to be online marketers, where if anything, I mean, even though it's unfortunate, like we've probably been making more money than ever since like everyone's been.
Well, yeah, I try not to tell people that, but yeah, everyone's like, oh, how's your business going? Like, has it been affected? And it's like, well, honestly, if anything, it's better because I think more people are just sitting at home staring at stuff on their phone.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, yeah, it is unfortunate, but it is like a benefit, I guess, to us, even though it sucks, you know, in general. But in saying that as well, like that's why YouTube's been like cranking lately, because I mean, even before COVID, like the watch time, if you watch like the amount of videos uploaded and like watch time on YouTube, it's just like skyrocketing. And now with everyone at home.
Yep. I know a lot of guys that do Facebook, guys and girls, but not YouTube. But I'd always hear like, you know, oh, I know a guy who is. But to be in that group and see, you know, people that are doing tens of thousands, even like $90,000 a day. I was like, yeah, I want a piece of that.
Yeah. We've had like 5 people do like 50K days on one offer in one niche, right? So that just goes to show that like the competition
out there.
Yeah. There's no like saturation. If we can have 5 people doing 50K days on like one offer, that's like, it's been insane to see.
Like when we were running Cinderella, and I'd see just how many sales are coming in every single day. It's hard to fathom numbers that big. Like you think like, once you've had, I don't know, like once an office had 50,000 sales, you'd think, oh, like surely everyone's seen it by now. But it's still kind of just scratching the surface. Like they can go way, way deeper than that. And like, yeah, this is YouTube. It's Google. It's like, it doesn't get any bigger.
Yeah. The biggest platform like on the world. And
yeah.
Yeah. You have an interesting perspective on that as well. Being a vendor, like how many people had been making sales like a day on your offer, would you say?
Yeah. Like I could go look it up, but it would be hundreds.
Yeah. Hundreds. Yeah. So it's,
yeah, it could even be over 1,000, like at our peak. I'd have to check, but
no,
easily hundreds.
Yeah. That's insane. Yeah. It's been awesome to actually like invite you into the group and like see your success so far. And I'm excited to see like how much further you're going to take it. A lot of people, they all say it's like the mindset, right? Because it always comes down to the mindset at the end of the day, even though a lot of people that are watching this might not think that, and they might think, oh, I just need this one like tactical, this one little trick. Would you agree that it does come down a lot to the mindset?
Like this, the system is, I guess, the tactic. And I think the mindset would be just following it, because if you start, you need to start by following the system. That's the control. And like, you should be able to make sales. Like there's literally no reason why you wouldn't make sales just following the system, picking a top offer.
Exactly. Well, I think that comes, a lot of people can get trapped in the mindset sort of stuff where they might even think there's like a mindset hack or something. But as you said, it's just like, you just need to put in the work. Like once you have the belief in the system and you have the confidence that the system works, all it takes is just like getting in the trenches and like just putting the work in, and also like never giving up as well. Like, you know, I'm sure you've had many times where you're running campaigns and they just flop, or, you know, even from Facebook to YouTube where things don't go as you want, but all you need to do is just like stay persistent to it. And
it's that's something to mention. So we keep saying 10 days, but it literally would have been like Monday would have been my seventh day or something, the big day. No, it was the ninth video that I made. And that's the one that just took off. So the others were okay. Some people might make 6, 7, 8 videos and be like, this doesn't work. But, you know, especially because it was my offer, I was like, well, I'm just going to keep going.
Yeah.
And it was the ninth one that really took off. So,
yeah, it's like that, that meme of like the guy digging a tunnel, and then he turns back and he's just like that close from like the diamonds.
Yeah.
I mean, I joined through Gary. So my biggest mindset thing through the entrepreneur mindset was like, stay laser focused, take massive action, never give up. And I think when you like have like full belief in a system, like that's all you really need. Like whether it takes you like 20 videos or takes you 9 videos or takes you 3 videos, each video you make is like one stepping stone to the breakthrough. And like you said, you have to take like 9 iterations of your video to really crack that winner.
Yeah. And I'll be launching number 17 today.
Yeah. There you go. Cause I mean, once you hit a winner, you can just keep improving and stuff. And
yeah.
Yeah. Awesome, man. So it's been a good call, and it's going to be good to continue watching your success go. So hope everyone enjoyed that interview, and we'll see you on the next one.
Awesome. Thanks, Chris.